Money, navigating money. Oh my God, what a minefield. I have been doing this for a long, long time, and there is no clear cut answer. It just shifts all the time. But I think the number one thing is that it can be fluid, with your clients. You don't have to say that my rate is X amount of pounds and I'm not deviating from that. I think you have to be fluid and open to the types of clients that you want to work with. And the primary number one question is, if somebody approaches you or you approach them to do a piece of work, it's like, well, what budget do you have to spend? Budget is so important. And people can be embarrassed about talking about money, but at the end of the day, we're not doing this for fresh air. We're doing it out of a love for creativity, but the end goal is to kind of put a roof over our head and food on our table. And that's why getting the money embarrassing stage over is so important. So asking what is the budget with your client is the number one question. And I would always do that every time, instead of saying, well, look, this is going to cost you X amount of pounds, and then the client goes and has a heart attack. You're better off starting with the question to them, what is your budget? How much have you got to play with? And from that, you can say, well, after that, you can say, well, what's the kind of remit of the project? What are your expected outcomes? And from that, you can start to break down the project and say, well, that particular project is going to take me a solid week's work. And I think that your budget might be a little tight, but what I could offer to do is give you X, Y, and Z for that budget and see how we go with that. And if that's successful, then we can move on to phase two, where you maybe secure a little bit more budget and work in that way. So in terms of being fluid and flexible, it's about forming a financial arrangement with your client, whereby you can do things in stages and say, well, we can do X and Y for this, and work it like that. So working out your rate is always a killer too, but there is a little bit of a kind of an equation around how to get to it. So your hourly or your daily rate could be your desired wage. So if you've come from an existing job and you need X amount of pounds per month to live, then you know that that's your kind of desired wage. But you can't forget about overheads. That could be rent. Operating costs and overheads are really important to remember. So that could be your kind of software subscriptions, all of your kind of direct debits in relation to your business, any overheads, printing costs, subcontractors. You've got to think about all of those things coming in too. So, and also the one thing that you should never forget about is taxes, because you always need to keep kind of 30% of whatever you take for the tax man. It depends whether you're VAT registered or not. But yeah, you'll always get a tax bill at the end of the day, and you do not want to be crying on the 31st of January when your bank account's empty and your accountant says to you, your bill is X, and you just want to cry. So I'm hesitant to talk about exact figures on rates because a lot of it depends on experience, things like that, and the type of work that you're selling as well. So you can also tier your rates, and we do this. We've got a low, medium, and high rate. So for example, for charity-based clients, we would have a lower rate for them. For medium clients, we would have a kind of standard rate for them. And then we've got a higher rate as well for clients who require a really kind of detailed, in-depth level of service, and that could be done work that's condensed into a really short time frame, or a project that really does require a really high level of skill and work. And that's when we would bring that kind of higher rate into play. So you can do it per level, per the sector that you're in, or by the level of work. If you know that it's going to be a really easy job and doesn't require a huge amount of brain power, you can have, for example, an artworking rate, and a design rate, and then a creative director rate, depending on the kind of level of work as well. So that's two ways to look at it. Look at it by the sector you're in or by the type of work that you're doing. And then navigating money, always value your work and always value yourself, because you can't say, oh, sure, give me 20 quid for that. You know, that'll do. And you have worked late nights for a whole week just to do that for a client. You're going to end up just in a bundle of tears and think, why did I do that? It really was not worth it. I got nothing out of it financially. The client didn't appreciate it because I only charged them 20 quid for it and they ran to the hills with it. So it really is about kind of valuing your work and also valuing yourself and realizing the effort and time and everything that you put into your work too.